Okay, let's start. Hello, my name is Alexander Korotkov. My talk is about index support for regular expression search. So it refers a problem when you need to search using regular expression on large string collection. The possible approaches to accelerate it could be so you can just do some faster matching of regular expression, or you can avoid do matching of each string in collection by using an index. Modern regular expression engines are already well optimized, and also do faster matching don't let you avoid full read of all string collection, and then index support for regular expression search is very urgent when you need to do such search on large string collection. At first, I would like to do a gentle introduction into regular expression, because almost all of us knows regular expressions, know how to write them, use them in practical tasks, but not all of us know underlying theory. But this theory in some minimum value is required to understand my speech. So we all know that regular expression is powerful tool for text processing, but not all of us know that it's based on formal language theory. Now we know it. And formal language theory introduced notion of language. Language is a state of strings, possible infinite set of strings. And also this theory says that regular expression are expressing same class of languages as finite automata. This means that we can transform regular expression to finite automaton, and then regular expression would have same set of matching strings as corresponding finite automaton. Moreover, such transformation is not only valuable for theory, but it is actually used by regular expression engines. So let's talk about what automaton is. Automaton is a graph which vertices are called states, and arcs are labeled by characters of string. And we say that automaton reads string if we can type that string by traversal between states from special state called initial state to some other special state called final state. Let's consider some example. We have such simple regular expression which reads strings which contain character A, then sequence of characters B, C, which can be repeated any amount of times, possibly zero amount of times, and then character D. This regular expression will be transformed to following automaton. In this automaton, initial state is marked by star, and final state is marked by number sign. So initial state have self-referencing arc, which matching to any characters. It means that we can start search this regular expression matching in any point of string, so we never lose this initial state. Then we can read character A, and we can read any amount of sequences BC by traversal to upper state and back. And then we can read character D and reach the final state. Final state also have self-referencing arc. It means that once we reach final state, we will never miss it. That means that if we find match, it doesn't matter what is Afterward, you anyway have matching. Your questions, please.
Don't you need a way to get out of the state at the top if you go if you get into if you get an A and then a B?
Yes.
Then if you get some other letter like F.
Then no of that states is activated. So this state was active, then this state becomes active. If next character is not C, neither of these states is active. But initial state remains active during whole process of matching. So in the moment of time could be active any count of states from zero to all states. Okay?
Wouldn't you want to keep reading the string? Wouldn't you want to go back to the initial state?
Actually, if no state is active, we can stop, because if no state is active, it will remain until end of the string, and we know that we will not reach the final state. I will consider some example. Probably it will clarify this thing. For example, we have such string, and initially, initial state is active. Then we read character X, and then no other state is activated, only initial state. Because the character is not A, but self-referencing arc work, and the initial state remain active. The same situation is repeated until we meet character A. When we meet character A, then it activates a state in the middle. Initial state remain active. It will remain active during all matching process, because it have self-referencing arc which match any character. Then we find character B, and then upper state is activated, and so on. Then we reach final state, and this state will remain active until end of the string. And when we reach end of the string and final state is active, we finish our matching process, and we can say that string is matching to regular expression. Okay.
Can you stop the first time you get to a final state?
Actually, yes, because it has a self-referencing arc. But I show this process without any optimization. Sure. So now all of us know something about regular expressions. Actually, this picture is not very relevant, because this guy just write regular expression. This doesn't mean he know underlining theory. But anyway, this is fun. Okay. Now about regular expression based search in a database. It's a good news that PostgreSQL can do regular expression based search, and while it's only a sequential scan, this is bad news. All of techniques to do regular expression based index search is based on inverted indexes on qgrams. Then I would like to do a gentle introduction into what inverted indexes of qgrams are. Qgram is the substring of original string which have a length q, and it can be used as signature of original string. What does it mean, signature of original string? It means that you can say something valuable about string without knowing of this string, by only knowing that some qgrams present in the string and some qgrams not present in the string. And the qgram technique is widely used in various string processing tasks, not only regular expression matching. For example, it also used in edit distance searching, in accelerated edit distance searching. And also, number of matching q-grams can be used as also some metric of string similarity, like in PGTRGM contrib model. Embedded index on q-grams maintain association between q-gram and all the strings where this q-gram is present. So PGTRGM has an implementation for some particular q, for q equal to 3. A little example of logical structure of PGTRGM index. It's not physical structure. Physical structure is much more complicated. It's just logical structure. For each q grams, you can find a number of strings where this q gram present. Something about q grams. Q grams have different frequencies in the strings. For example, DBLP paper titles, which amount is 2.5 million, contains very many titles which contain trigrams there. It's the most common trigram in English language. But if we find, if we would like to find titles which contain trigrams ZZZ, there is only one title containing Z trigram. So this title I get my interest, and I present information about it. Probably somebody also interested in what is the only one title containing ZZZ. So not all q grams of fixed q are equally useful. For example, you probably don't like to get the posting list, the list of string where trigram Z is present, because it is very large. Probably you can do better without getting such list. Probably it would produce more false positive, but it anyway will be quickly. To avoid these minuses of the trigrams of fixed Q, can be used variable length grams, so-called V grams or multigrams. This means that each Q gram can have specific Q, so that make selectivity of all Q grams similar. So we can do selectivity of them equal, but we can do make it to be in some not very wide range. For example, if some trigram is very frequent, we can use 4 grams in such case. And if some trigram is very rare, we probably would like to group such trigrams into D gram. And this could lead to more effective index search. But there are some problems to get this into Postgres, because when some paper describes techniques of V-grams of multigrams, they describe it like we have some fixed street collection, and once we collect frequencies and build index, they don't describe how we can maintain it online, because in Postgres we can say user, if you build index, you can't insert or update or delete in the table. It's unreasonable. This is the first problem. This problem is avoidable. But there is also second problem. Second problem is patents, and patent trolls. Because many scholar papers have corresponding patents which prevent us to implement this in open source database. Probably this it is avoidable because we can use some another algorithms, but I'm not a lawyer and I don't know if these patterns cover the whole idea of trigrams, and there is not way to avoid these patterns. So I will post this question to PG advocacy, and probably they will help to resolve this problem.
Probably not a good idea to mention the patents, actually.
What?
Especially, it's probably not a good idea to mention or read the patents
in the United States.
It's too late anyway.
I suggest you not mention that when you post to the mailing list about this.
I'm not sure we can discuss this later.
No, it's all about legal law.
Yes. The next question is how to use such indexes for regular expression search. General idea is so, when we have some regular expression, we can write some logical expression which express which trigrams should be present in the string in order to this string can be matched to regular expression. This doesn't mean that it should necessarily match. It allows some false positives, but don't allow false negatives. For example, in this case, we have that first character should be A or B. Then there should be necessary trigram ACD or BCD. And the last three characters are just continuous fraction of string, sequence of exact three characters, and this means that trigram CDE should necessarily present. Then we get posting list for all of these three trigrams. For all numbers of string, we get the table which presents for each trigram. Is it present in following string or not? Then we can evaluate this logical expression, and if a logical expression is true, we can fetch original string from heap. And when we fetch original string from heap, we can do recheck using actual regular expression. But result can be false because our logical expression allow false positives. General idea is so, but the challenge is how to do this in general case. In this case, is very evident, but to do this in general case is not so easy. Let's consider existing approaches for such Q-gram extraction. The first is a scholar paper called Fast Regular Expression Indexing Engine. And this paper is still widely referenced in as a state of art work about this problem. In short, this method is so. We extract only continuous string fraction from regular expression and ignores other part in some way. And then we transform this continuous fraction to multigrams. And when we get logical expression on multigrams, we can use inverted index. Let's consider some example. We have for this example regular expression, we get following tree. It consists of logical operations, continuous strings, and there is a symbol x, which can be repeated any amount of times. We represent it as a star which have a child of x character. Then we replace star with null. Null in general means that it is something we don't know what. Then if we have something we don't know what under O, because it's O, we actually don't know what is the whole subtree. And then the corresponding parent O will be replaced with null. But when null is the child of end, we can just remove null, because we know that this part is present and something we don't know what. We can just remove it. Also, we can remove some unnecessary elements and then replace this with some q grams. For example, it is 3 grams. Another existing approach was Google Code Search. Google Code Search was launched in 2006, and Google Code Search supported regular expression search on open source code. This was very interesting for me when I found it, and I thought that Google guys are smart. It can be that they do a sequential scan of the whole amount of source code. And it also seemed to me that they do something better than that paper, something more smarter, but we don't know what. Actually, we didn't know what they do until Google Code Search closed, and then Google engineer Russ Cox published a description of this indexing technique in January 2012 on his website. So it was more 5 years of intriga when we can use Google Code Search and didn't know how it works. Now we can use Google Code Search, but now we know how it worked. So a brief description of its method. It collect 5 characteristics about each part of regular expression. It's mutable. It's just Boolean which represents can this part of regular expression be matched to absent string, empty string or not. Exact, probably this part of regular expression only matches to some exact set of things, then we fill the property exact. The prefix and suffix means that this regular expression necessary require for string to have some prefix and suffix. And match means that that regular expression part requires some string to be in any part of the matching string. And then they recursively union these characteristics of regular expression by some rules and use inverted index of onTrigram for query evaluation. This index is very similar to PGTRGM. Some example. We have the same regular expression as in the first example. At first, we get properties of continuous strings, so it's easy, it's just exact. When we apply the plus symbol, we know that this regular expression would require from string to have this prefix and this suffix. So it's pretty easy. When we add characters at the start of regular expression, we add it to the prefix. And when we add it to the end of string, we add it to the suffix. Then transformation is so. We get characteristics of the original expression, and then we can easily transform it to the logical expression on trigrams. Okay, now we considered existing approach, and I would like to talk that proposed method, the method which I propose for use. My method is not based on analysis of original regular expression, but based on analysis of corresponding automaton, and transform it to some automaton-like graph. But this graph have not characters on its axis, but trigrams. Then we could possibly simplify that graph and then use PGTRGM indexes. So it's quite difficult to explain the whole method formally. Then I would like to explain it on the example. Let's consider some regular expression. It's this regular expression is character A. Then it reads any amount of character B, at least one character B or C. And in the end, it reads character D. There is a corresponding automaton for this regular expression. And now we can start our transformation. The first step is easy. We just put initial state of resulting graph. And then we start to assign to this resulting graph a keys. The key is two things. At first, it pair of the last read characters and the number of the state. For example, for initial state of automaton, we can read character A and then character B and reach state 2. So our key is corresponding to state 2 and last read characters was AB. Similar, we can reach characters AB and reach state 4. And so on. We can read AC and reach state 3 and read AC and reach state 4. Then it's all possible case for initial state. And then we should look into what we what another states we can reach from this case. For if we are in character in state 2 and last read characters was AB, according to source automaton, we can read character B. This means that trigram ABB necessary present in the string, and then last read character is characters is BB, and we are still in the state 2. According to another arc of original automaton, we also can reach state 4 by same trigram and same last read characters. Also, we can read character D from state 4. And if last read characters was AB, then trigram ABD necessary present in the string. And then last read characters is BD and state 5. And important moment is that corresponding state of original automaton is final, then corresponding state of the resulting graph is also marked as final. And we do similar thing for another key. And then when we have finished processing this initial state, we start processing that state which was made by previous. If we can use self-referencing art of the state 2, and then we can read the trigram BBB and live in this in the same state, it will be self-referencing art. So the similar transformation, I will not describe it at all. I think the idea is understandable now. Then we get some resulting graph. What is important property of this graph? So if some string is matching to regular expression and matching to corresponding automaton, then we can traverse from initial state of resulting graph to final state of this resulting graph by only traversing in the arc which trigrams is present in string. So this property allow us to treat this graph as logical expression on trigrams and use this on the previously described method of of regular expression search. This result could be simplified because we can reach from here to here reading ABB by we require only trigram ABB, so we also can reach this by reading ABB and BBB trigrams, but it doesn't matter if just ABB is enough. So we can simplify this. The implemented simplification technique is to collect following matrix. This matrix represents all possible minimal passes which can bring us from original state to final state, and this matrix can be easily transformed by transformed to logical expression. For example, for the first string, only one is for trigram ABD, and then ABD trigram is first summoned. Then the second line of this table, trigrams ABB and BBD, and this means that the second summoned is ABB and BBD trigrams, and so on for another lines of the table. Some comparison of different techniques of trigrams logical expression extraction from regular expression. For this regular expression, fast regular expression indexing engine, the shortcut is free. Can extract regular expression only containing some, only containing continuous fraction of string. Google code search method could give a more comprehensive expression, and my method produce some similar logical expression, but not in such simple form. It has some duplication. Another example, because there is no continual fraction of string, because C have a plus, and C plus will be replaced as null, and then no trigrams can be extracted, no continuous trigrams can be extracted from here, and the free method can't extract something. Google code search can see that ABC and CD trigrams should be present, and my method see something more not only ABC and CDE, but also there should be BCD or the pair of trigrams BCC and CCD. There are also some examples where neither free method and Google Code Search method can extract any trigrams. So Google Code Search method is confused by this star and inside plus. It's probably too complicated because it can't see any fixed suffix because this character C can be repeated any amount of times, including zero amount of times. Also, some examples where free method and Google Search method can't do something. And performance result on DBLP paper titles. A regular expression, for example, it's not real life regular expression, it's just something I write for the testing. And we can see some pretty dramatical difference between index scan and sequence scan. And also we can see that the time is increased when regular expression become longer. It's because the longer regular expression, we can extract more trigrams for it, and we should read more of posting lists. This is also avoidable because if we had selectivity of trigrams, then we could ignore some of them, getting more false positive, but having to read less of posting lists. So there are some optimization are possible. Even if we don't know selectivity of trigrams, we can anyway decide to exclude some trigrams from our search. Work in progress patch was posted to the mailing list. This patch is based on PGTRGM contrib model. Any feedback to this patch is welcome. This patch is work in progress, and there are still some problems in it. The first problem is that transformed graph could be very large. So in this case, we possibly should decide that when transformed graph reach some size, we should say that we should stop doing it and do just full index scan. Also, process of simplification could produce very large table of possible passes. In this case, we probably should don't try to create such table, but use the just transformed graph. And also, usage of trigrams for this particular task is not optimal. It would be better to use variable length grams. In my presentation, I did some simplification for more easier understanding, and I would like to mention that in order to my presentation wouldn't be disinformation for somebody. I didn't mention difference between deterministic and non-deterministic automata. So deterministic automata can have only one arc marked with same character from same state. Then we deal here only with non-deterministic automata, but regular expression engines actually transforms non-deterministic automata to deterministic in order to do faster match, because in deterministic automaton only one state can be active in same time. It's very good for performance. Also, in real life, regular expression engines don't mark arcs with exact characters, because, for example, there could be some meta symbol of regular expression, which, for example, representing any numeric character or any space character or just any word character. And this means that there will be very many arcs. And then regular expression engines group characters into colors. Colors is a group of characters which are indistinguishable by regular expression. And also, regular expression engines have some special method for handling start and end of string, of the whole string, or the line of it. In short, it can be done by representation start and end as some special characters. For example, in our example how regular expression work, we didn't use some start and end characters, but the regular expression engines use it. My project also needs some help. I need a string collection and regular expression from real life tasks to prove effectiveness of my method and also finding some corner cases and optimize them. So if you have some data sets for me, it would be great. You should contact me. So now thank you for attention. Ask your questions, please. Okay. Trigrams, because we already have indexes on trigrams implemented in Postgres. But it could be done with, for example, digrams, fograms, and if we can evade problem with patterns, it would be better to use variable length grams. Yes, yes. It is so.
Is it possible that picking the right length is something you can do using stats to know which ones are actually common? Like, if
you, the question is about selection of Q and Q grams or not.
So if you built an index that
okay.
had trigrams,
okay.
Then you could decide which lengths to look up in the index based on the stats saying that there are if there are actually not enough trigrams to make a selective enough lookup, then you could expand the regex further and look for quadrams. But you would have to look at the stats to know which ones are more common or less common.
You said about built index which contains, for example, the both 3 grams and 4 grams. Yes, it's also interesting possible approach.
Can you go back to your examples?
Okay. These examples. Which particular slide?
The ones where you show the time of.
What?
Next slide.
This? Okay. About.
Does that just generate a lot of trigrams? Like, as ABC.
What about negative character classes?
Are you asking for the.
You're
asking for the logical expression on trigrams for that examples?
What I'm curious was that most of your examples use specific individual characters for everything. Is the reason that the very first example there is the slowest? Is it the.
This actually not because it's just ignores this character because there are too many characters matching any character. It's slower just because it's longer. It's longer than it's not because this part, but because the whole number of trigrams of another part is larger, and possibly they have the greater selectivity and larger posting lists, and it's because of this. Okay.
Actually, I wanted to ask the same question. So you have more trigrams, but they're more selective, like you said, because they're mostly M's here.
Not. If I have a more complicated expression on trigrams, I have less false positives. So I get less fetch the heap. But I get more, I have to read more posting lists. And there is a trade-off between amount of false positives and reading posting lists.
Right. Yeah, so you could decide.
Yes.
You don't need to read them all.
Yes. If some posting list is large and also it doesn't influence the false positives very much with some estimation, I should decide not to read that posting list and remove it from logical expression. Any other questions? To what?
Multi-byte characters.
Yes, it's possible. You might be reference that PGTRGM converts multi-byte characters to the hash sums. Yes, it's also possible to do to build index on multi-byte characters. It will have to make the keys Warlena. It will add some additional size of index, but it's definitely possible. And also it would have some advantages, because, for example, you index trigrams and you would like to find all strings that continue some dgram which this trigram starts, and you can do this using partial match. When you have hash sums, you can't do so. So this would be possibly better solution for this particular task. Yes?
I apologize if I missed it, but did you say how long it took to build the indexes that were used for these examples?
I didn't say that because for a while, it's not novelty of my work. It's just same PGTRGM index as it is in head. Any other questions? Yes?
I guess I have one that's a variation on other comments that were made, which is if you looked at the list of trigrams that you had and you had frequencies for those trigrams, then you could start by doing the queries for the
Yes, sure, but yes, but it's not so easy to implement in Postgres because the kind of collecting statistics is not dependent on index now, and also from the interface method of an index implementation, you can't get any statistic information. There are two problems, but ideally we would collect statistic about trigrams when we have corresponding index and can get the statistics from interface function and do this optimization. Yes, it is the right way and I would like to do it. Any other questions? It seems that not.
Regular expressions that don't have trigrams. If I say backslash W plus dot backslash D.
For, yes, there are many regular expressions where we can't extract any trigrams. Yes, in this case, we just should do some sequential scan. For example, if you are searching using gene index, then planner call extract query on the stage of plan. And if that this extract query says that I can do something better than full index scan, then planner decide to don't do an index scan and do sequential scan, which is faster than full index scan in this case. So if we have regular expression which for which no trigrams can be extracted, you just will fall back to sequential scan. I think it's unavoidable. Any other questions? Yes.
Can you go back a couple of slides, please?
Okay.
Your expression, what do they look like? How are they represented? Is this a tree of nodes?
I didn't understand.
In the bottom two lines?
Yeah.
Please repeat the question.
How do you represent that in memory?
I actually represent in memory as this table. So I write this logical expression only for better explanation, but I just iterate over lines of table and check if all the trigrams with marked with one actually present in string. If it's so, I stop the iterating and say that the result is true. So the string possibly matching regular expression. And if I reach the end of table without it, I return false. This means that string definitely don't matching to regular expression. There is already existing operator in PostgreSQL. I just add this operator to operator class in PGTRGM contrib module. My patch just contains this additional line in the SQL file. Any other questions? Yes?
Is there
negative matches? You mean negative matches? For example, decide that some string which match regular expression should definitely don't contain some trigram. Yes? Do you mean that? Possibly, but this regular expression should be both prefix regular expression and suffix regular expression. So it shouldn't contain some part which can be which can contain anything between if yeah, regular okay. expression contains this part, then no, it's possible. Also, if we don't allow this. We deal with some particular class of Boolean function. It's a class called monotonic Boolean function because there is no negative, and dealing with this is easier. Possibly I will find some better ways to do simplification because it's monotonic. It simplifies our analysis. Any other questions? It seems that no questions remains. Okay. Thank you.